Hi, I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. This week, we have two questions from viewer Rebecca Savage in San Antonio. First, what's going on with her sago palm? Rebecca says that it faces north and has been in this spot for over 5 years. This year and last, it turned yellow in the winter and early spring. It had new growth last year after she trimmed off the yellowed stems. Well, Rebecca, your sago palm is showing frost damage. Although in general, our winters are pretty mild, this year had some especially long-lasting cold temperatures, which tropical species like your cycad aren't used to. You were right to trim off the damaged tissue last year. It won't recover. But the new growth should be just fine, and it isn't hard to protect such small, slow-growing plants as your sago palm from frosty temps. If the cold spell is predicted to be brief, simply cover with a blanket or heavy sheet, anchoring the fabric down at the base with bricks or other heavy objects to make sure no heat escapes from the microclimate you've created underneath. If, like last year, the temperatures are freezing for a longer period of time, you could add a string of Christmas lights to the equation, being careful to provide some sort of frame to hold them so as not to cause a fire hazard. And be sure to use some of the older style lights, not the new LED ones, which don't produce enough heat. And Rebecca also wants to know what's going on with her spineless prickly pear cactus. This appears to be some sort of physical damage, possibly frost or maybe insect damage or even hail, that's now led to open wounds where microbes have invaded and caused some tissue decay. I can also see that the plant is severely infested with scale insects. Once you notice some new growth, remove the new pads and replant them. Unfortunately, the mother plant will not recover. Our plant of the week is Cenizo, also known as Texas sage and rain sage. There are many great species of this native shrub, and all are drought and heat tolerant. Leaves among species vary from silver gray to bright green, and flowers are mostly some variety of purple, from lavender to deep magenta. Size is also quite variable, and Cenizo are mostly happy when not overly pruned. So pick the species that will fit in your allotted space with the foliage and floral color combination that you find most appealing. Water sparingly once established, and even then, only in the driest, hottest of times. Plant in full sun, in loose, well-drained, even rocky soil. But if you have a bit of clay in your soil, Cenizo will also tolerate that as long as it drains well and you don't overwater. Our viewer picture and video comes from Patsy Lamb in Waco, who's created an outdoor sanctuary with pansies and bird feeders against a sign that reads, "Gardening soothes the soul." Cardinals snuggle in the pansies between bites at the feeder. We'd love to hear from you. Head over to KLU.org/CTG to send us your questions, pictures, and videos.